Hi there, my name is Carrie Zeki. I'm a finance student at Curtin University Malaysia, majoring in marketing and management. And soon in a month, I'll be graduating. So I'm quite excited to see what does the future hold. Well, what you're watching right now is my career passport refresher video for the unit Enhancing Your Business Mind. In this video today, I will be sharing about my employability 2 visa, my journey with this unit, my reflection and time spent at Curtin University, my career plan, and lastly, a message to my future self. Let's start, shall we? So at the start and end of the semester, I completed 2 employability skill tests, which helped me identify my strengths and weaknesses based on 6 literacies. After knowing what my weaknesses are, I was determined to improve them throughout this semester. Hence, you can see them on the result here. There's a noticeable difference between the result from week 1 and week 12. When you compare my result, my basic rhetorical, personal and critical literacy has drastically improved, which checks out my journey with Curtin and this unit. This improvement and contribution to the fact that critical thinking and effective communication skills plays a crucial role in most of the assignments in this unit. This can be evident based on my current performance in Curtin and my job. For example, my recent success in leading a small and diverse team. I realize I am more confident addressing challenges and speaking up my own opinions during the weekly activities. I am also able to analyze rationally to come to a judgment through sincerely researching articles and interviewing them into my assignments. Hence, the result of week 12. Next, this reflection is based on my experience in this unit. I would definitely agree that most of the activities did force me to stay out of my comfort zone, as they also forced me to be receptive in working with different members every week. Throughout this whole semester, there are a few activities that stood out to me the most, and one of them was the Minecraft education. Aside from it being very fun, it also tested out my collaborative, my creative and communication skills, as they require us to work in a large group to building our own virtual city and virtual bedroom. Meanwhile, the Getty pitch had taught me to be more confident and fully engaged with my listeners, and it tested my ability to pitch regarding information in brief without getting a chance to be prepared beforehand. This activity was a bit tough, but I would say it could be very useful for me in the future when I have to start selling myself and my value to future employers and allowed me to stand out during the selection process in the working world. Next, the capsule inbox had me working under pressure, which is a very important trait for me to have when I start working. I have to be able to perform effectively regardless of how much pressure is there. For example, meeting a certain due date also provide a spot to present something. Lastly, for all the topics in EYBN, ethics and sustainability made me realize that fairness and integrity is very important in my personal life and also my workplace. I must act in accordance with my words, own up with my mistake, and also treat everybody fair and well. All in all, the positive aspect of this unit is there's something new to learn every week, which made me look forward to attend class every week. I'm also really grateful for the breakout session in this unit, as it was quite challenging for me to know new people since every class is held online right now. So I'm really grateful for these breakout sessions, as many new friendships were made. Here comes my reflection on my time spent at Curtin University. I'm sure everyone has heard before that university marks the best time in your life, and yes, I do agree with that. Studying in Curtin definitely was the best choice I ever made, and I really did enjoy my academic and non-academic life in Miwi. I believe I've chosen the right course for myself, as I managed to excel in my studies while enhancing my life experience. Throughout my years in Curtin, I also joined the Curtin Career Entertainment Club back in 2018 as a normal member, but soon was promoted as secretary and also a vice president. I gained numerous exposure in organizing monthly events and also our Curtin Korean Dance competition, which involved many local dancers of all over Malaysia. I also gained many experience on how to organize events, look for sponsorships, and also work with a large group of people with different attitudes and backgrounds. Aside from that, I'm also very active in volunteering for different events where I step out of my comfort zone and also build a sense of accomplishment, pride, and identity. I was a volunteer for Zero Shades, where I had to take care of shelter animals every week. I was also part of the Running Club, One Punch Cancer Challenge Run, and many more other events. University was a place where I met many new lifetime friends and gained many life lessons that you don't really learn from the books, and of course to learn more about myself and what I want to achieve in life. Despite my hectic schedule during university, I managed my time in creating daily to-do lists and focus on my priorities. As my career plan, my next steps after graduating is hopefully to secure a job position in the fashion retail industry, where I serve as a fashion marketing manager to help brands to determine the best market for themselves and also creative skills to develop strategies and campaigns to increase sales. In order to achieve my career path, I will ensure my CV is up to standard with my working experience, education, and relevant industry skills. As soon as my job starts to stable, I will sign myself up for online courses to improve myself in digital marketing skills and product marketing skills. Other than that, in order to be fully engaged in the fashion industry, I aim to boost my name and portfolio by releasing more fashion-related projects, leveraging my personal social media, research latest industry trends, which is actually part of my responsibility to stay relevant and also informed in order to ensure my company reaches the targeted KPI. I also be very active on LinkedIn and follow prominent figures and brands to catch up and be updated with their current development and progress. Let's move on to the part of what will I tell my future self. But first, this is the audacity plan that I came up with on what I would like to achieve in the next 5 years. During the first year, I would love to secure a job position as a fashion marketing manager. And during the second year, I would love to attend more online classes with surfer tickets and know more about the e-commerce industry. As my third year, I would love to continue my master in Master of Business Administration while working. In my fourth year, I hope to establish an SME with some trusted friends whereby I have multiple incomes and be less worried in my workplace that don't pay me on time. And lastly, for my fifth year, I am expected to finish my master by then and also to experience career growth and development and also hopefully to grow my SME into the international market. Here comes the part of what will I tell my future self. Hi future Carrie, so this is a quote that I find quite inspiring to me. I hope it inspires you as well. Success is not final, failure is not fatal. It is the courage to continue that counts. Don't be afraid of fall. Not everyone has the courage to admit their failure. Actually, failure does open a lot of doors to unexpected success. So yes, you are brave. So the next step you need to do is just get back on your feet and move forward. Life still goes on. Have faith, be positive, and there's better things ahead of you. Well, the next thing probably I want to say is I hope you're doing what you're passionate about, but not some job that pays you a very high salary. But if that is what is stopping you from doing what you like, then just get out there. You're just staying in your comfort zone and not challenging yourself. So go challenge yourself. It may not be as bad as you think, and the future self will thank the current you for making that choice. In conclusion, this video covered the employability tool where I saw the highest in ethical, cultural and social literacies and the lowest in emotional literacies. Therefore, my goal is to take the necessary measurements to improve my weakest literacies to boost my overall employability. Next, based on my reflection on the unit enhancing a business mind, it had tremendously helped me improve my critical thinking, communication, leadership and creativity skills. And I was able to evaluate myself through the weekly reflection reports. Meanwhile, my time in Curtin has flourished me into the person I am today, as I have a balance of academic and non-academic life that made me have many new friends and also enjoyed my university carefree life. As my career plan, I aim to become a fashion marketing manager and will ensure I equip myself with the relevant experience and skills required for this position. Lastly, a message to my future self is to not be afraid of failure and challenge myself and step out of my comfort zone. This is the end of my video. Thank you and I wish you all the best. Stay safe.